no grave can hold my body down. There ain't no grave can hold my body down.
Good cold evening, gentlemen. Amongst your inventory, I've been led to believe is a specimen I'm keen to acquire.
When I hear the trumpet sound,
what's your name?
I'm gonna rise right out of the ground.
Django. Then you're exactly the one I'm looking for.
Hey, stop talking to him.
Calm down. I'm simply a customer trying to conduct a transaction.
Last chance, fancy pants.
Oh, very well.
Every now and then, there is a movie in every moviegoer's life in which that moviegoer must go against the current of everybody else's universal opinion to be a truthful and sincere and unapologetic movie critic. But why the f*** did it have to be Django Unchained? Quentin Tarantino's Spaghetti Southern was one of my most anticipated movies of the year. Set against the backdrop of slave-era South, Django, a slave named after the genre this movie's exploiting, is freed by dentist-turned-bounty hunter Dr. King Schultz. The two partner up for a bounty-hunting journey that eventually leads them on a dangerous mission to save Django's enslaved wife from the hands of plantation owner Calvin Candy. It is a somewhat simple revenge story that becomes expanded as the film goes along, but it manages to do it in the charming yet sadistic Tarantino style that we've all come to know and most of us love. However, for me, there were enough things I found troublesome enough to keep me from fully loving it, sadly. I'll start off by saying that I loved the entire first half of this film. It has all the classic Tarantino tropes I enjoy, including superb dialogue, great performances from Jamie Foxx and Christoph Waltz, over-the-top yet fun violence, and well-written comedy. Seeing Django and Schultz partner up and build this strong partnership made me wish there was a whole show built around these two going on various bounty hunting adventures. The first half is also packed with great cinematography, some neat shootout scenes, and a genre-defining soundtrack. That's not to say this is omitted from the second half of the film, I just merely took greater notice of it during this first half. Now please allow me to explain myself after I utter the following phrase. My problems with the film didn't start showing up until Leonardo DiCaprio's character gets introduced, and it starts going downhill from there. Now, that doesn't mean that poor old Leo ruined the film, not at all. But for me, it is simply a terrible coincidence that what I didn't like about the movie started right when he came on screen. Leonardo DiCaprio is an outstanding actor and is way overdue for an Oscar, no doubt about it. But I personally didn't feel his performance was as amazing as everyone is saying it is. It's a great performance, but there was something about his accent and his mannerisms that felt, for me, inspired by other classic cinematic villains. Although I must say, he does eventually become quite scary as the film goes on, but mainly towards the end. Samuel L. Jackson, who plays Stephen, Candy's right-hand man, was great at first, but then he would become a little schizophrenic with his performance, going from being a crazy old fart with nervous tics, who still managed to be just as intimidating as Candy, but then he went to being Samuel L. Jackson, covered in makeup, saying, "Mother." Some scenes dragged a little too long, and Tarantino himself appears in a speaking role. Yeah, Quint, stick to simple cameos. Also, without spoiling anything, it ends like most Tarantino movies end. It's fine to see that after a film or two, but after seeing that kind of ending a number of times, I wish Tarantino would try something new with his endings. Nevertheless, despite all my problems with it, the second half does lead up to a more than decent payoff in the form of a beautifully gruesome shootout scene drenched in the Tarantino violence we've come to enjoy to watch. It is definitely a film I would recommend to any Tarantino or Western enthusiast that would want something fresh and new, and it's still a bloody good time regardless. But personally, the film slows down a bit after introducing its antagonist, and the absence of Sally Mank, Tarantino's original former longtime editor, God bless her soul, is felt here with a few slightly stretched out scenes. There are also some script issues that nagged me a little bit. I would have loved to have seen Django evolve into the lightning fast gunslinger he is, and I would have liked to have seen the relationship between Candy and Steven explored more and see why Steven stays by his side. Not to mention, a character that I really, really liked does something that so far has appeared quite dumb for me, and I have yet to decipher why he did it, despite various interpretations. But Tarantino's violent and darkly comedic style is more than welcome here, and like I said, I love the entire first half of the film, as well as a number of things from the second half, especially that shootout scene. And although I have my issues with the way Tarantino unfolds his endings, he still manages to make a captivating last shot and line. I give Django Unchained an 8.5 out of 10, which is a B. For more reviews, click the channel link below, and thank you guys for watching.
In my world, you gotta get dirty. So that's what I'm doing. I'm getting dirty.
What's your name?
Django. D-J-A-N-G-O. The D is silent.
Adult supervision is required.